The Leo and Danny Show.
I think one person in this room, though, had a worse week than the rest of them. Yeah. Austin. I know you're happy that Joe Biden won, but I heard you got a flat tire on the freeway the other week.
Damn, dude. Yeah, was it like, what was it like when you saw the loss in front of you? Was it like a sports team? I know you don't really follow too many. Actually, you're kind of a sports fan. Or was it more of like a personal thing? Like, was it a personal loss or like a... You grew attached to a team.
I'm sorry, just to set this up a little bit. Austin, if you haven't listened to this podcast at all, this is your first time. Maybe Airsoft Fatty is going to bring in views.
Right.
Austin is a diehard conservative. Yes. One could even say fanatical and delusional.
Deranged, yeah, absolutely.
He's deranged in other ways in his life, but delusional political conservative,
right.
I guess.
Yeah. His nickname alt-right Austin. No. It's a little bit of an exaggeration. He's not exactly alt-right, but he could hang out with a couple guys that are alt-right.
Yeah. I wouldn't go that far.
He could get unmasked in a Klan meeting and they wouldn't make him leave the campfire.
They wouldn't even flinch.
Yeah.
He could be, I mean, if he went back in time, he would fit right in with the Klansmen. He would be at the town hall meetings. He would be he'd be right there.
Now I would probably do best in like the 1940s.
Yeah,
I disagree. I think you would do
Germany.
Well, slavery.
And any time there was hatred of dark colored skin people, I think you could be the head of the KKK's son, who is like a promising young minister at the church.
Oh yeah, and he would get mad pussy, but he would have sex with black girls like and just tell nobody.
But
impregnate one maybe and like have to kill her. Like,
your KKK fucking... dad catches you with a black chick in bed and just beats her.
I could also see Austin.
God, he'd beat your ass.
On top of being that guy, I could see a lot of neighborhood pets turning up dead in the woods with Austin's fingerprints on him.
Oh, yeah. And he would do it. Or, yeah, absolutely. And he would do his best to just blame, the blacks for all the deaths of the kittens and stuff like that. Yeah. He would blame all
the. And the sad thing is at that time, the blacks would probably get lynched over it too.
Yeah.
Fluffy went missing?
Fucking
Bernard? I feel like they didn't have two.
They didn't have the names that we're come to, I think, know now, like Dante, for example.
Dante Culpepper,
for example, yeah. I feel like the names back then were right. I feel like they were just their own. They were probably given to them by the whites, so.
Yeah. So you want to know my thoughts on the election?
Yeah,
yes.
I'm sorry.
Also, we're on a tangent.
We also have Dom's coming soon. This is
nice.
Unfortunately, an annoying part of the show is we don't have an assistant to retrieve guests. But Austin, tell us what you think about the election.
All right. Well, to add some context, I streamed the election on my live stream channel, which is like
nice
below.
Nice plug.
Same shameless plug.
Uh-huh. Little plug.
But I titled my live stream "Landslide Election Time, Baby," and for about 4 hours, we just went through every single individual county. I mean, I thought Trump was going to win. I still think he's probably going to end up winning with the legal battle, to be honest.
Oh, what's happening with the legal battle? Because I don't see how it's possible at this point now that everybody's assumed that Biden's the winner. Mm-hmm. When I look at the thingy on Google, it says Biden's the winner. Mm-hmm. To me, that's as far as it goes. What are you saying is happening with these Trump lawsuits?
Okay, it's pretty complicated, so I'll sum it up as compactly as I can.
I'd appreciate that.
So the race has been called by the media. It's not official. The electoral college and stuff, the electors don't actually vote until like January or whatever. Biden's not actually the president-elect. It's just the media forecast that.
Okay.
Now, Trump has issued various legal battles in 6 different states. And in all of these states, the gap between the votes is like 6,000 votes to like 60,000 towards Biden. As you know,
in the battleground states like
Arizona,
Georgia, Nevada, Arizona, Michigan. And what you speak of, you're talking about your landslide stream. Leo and I were on the plane the night of the election coming back to LA. It was right after our heroics that you could see on my Instagram.
Oh, yeah.
Soon you're going to be able to see it on a full YouTube video where we tailgated voting for Trump, caused a big hullabaloo.
Oh, yeah.
Had a newsman cover us and put us on the news. But while we were on the plane, Leo was showing me the map and it looked like Trump was pulling ahead and favored. A lot of my other conservative buddies were texting me, telling me the same thing.
Yep.
And then you wake up the next morning, different story.
Yeah,
because I was up late and it got to a point, I don't know, maybe it was like 11 o'clock at night where they said, all right, it's too late. We're going to stop the count. Our people are tired. No more counting. And then at about 4 o'clock in the morning, you see just a huge jump. And Biden flips basically all of these states overnight.
which is the perfect time to do something surreptitiously and illegal and pull a move like that one that gets your man into the White House. I believe this stuff, the conspiracy theories that people are going around with.
Did you vote? Did you see how easy it is to vote? You literally just tell them your birthday in California. That's the only form of authentication. I gave them my packet.
Hey, I'll one up you, Austin. We went up to one of the ladies who incidentally was a Trump voter, who was driving the van from polling station to polling station collecting the boxes of ballots, and it was just an old lady and her fucking husband. Yeah. There was no cop with them. There was no guy with a badge who worked for the federal government.
Right.
Who's to say she was a Trump voter, but who's to say some lady in Santa Barbara County or Santa Cruz County who's got dreadlocks and cats couldn't just fucking take that van, park it on the edge of a cliff, and then push it while in neutral into the sea?
I mean, there are even videos of people on TikTok that like worked during the election counting that were like tearing up votes. Like,
that is so that's a federal offense. I feel like that's absolutely nuts. Somebody would do that.
The previous mayor of New York, he's Donald Trump's lawyer, for anyone who doesn't know. Yep. And he says he already has 70 eyewitness testimonies ready to go in court just for the state of Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They officially uncalled Pennsylvania on Real Clear Politics, which is probably the most accurate counting website.
Well, that's Real Clear.
And then on CNN, they had to uncall Arizona. Okay. And if Trump wins Arizona and wins the legal case and Pennsylvania, because a lot of it isn't even fraud. It's that Pennsylvania kind of, they had their Supreme Court change the rules on how they do the voting when it comes to mailouts, when in the Constitution it says it's up to the state's legislature, which is their
legislator,
the legislative branch of the state government, instead of
legislative.
The Supreme Court.
You're saying legislative. There's an R where it shouldn't be.
Oh, okay.
It's okay.
Make sure you perform your line later to Airsoft Fatty in a good vernacular. We need you to really clearly state that.
Thank you, Leo. Grammar is important when you're calling a guy a fat faggot. Or whatever Leo
fat motherfucker.
Yeah, we don't want to,
fat faggot?
We don't want to inquire about his sexuality.
He might be gay, dude.
He probably is, dude. He's probably a bestiality, or he's got a lot of cats.
We should make like fucking Brooks like motorboat his titties or something.
I'm down, Leo. My feelings on the election, and I've been thinking about this a lot this week, is that the conspiracy theories, I fucking buy them, dude. The reason being, since Trump got into office, before Trump got into office, there has been this dark, artificial feeling sentiment towards Donald Trump where everybody hates him, and I feel like most of the people who hate him couldn't even explain to you why they hate him, but they must because it's mandatory. And that is on a personal basis, the kids you go to school with, people you work with, and it goes all the way up to fucking Jimmy Kimmel, Seth Meyers, every talk show host. You get the feeling that they're having meetings, weekly meetings with Tide and Coca-Cola, like, all right, you need to make 10 jokes and say Trump's a fat piece of shit this week, otherwise we're pulling our sponsorship. The sense that's going on. The way that tech handles Trump, the way that all these big corporations deal with the guy, you get the feeling that something behind the scenes of what we can see, something that's not in our visual wavelength, to use a metaphor for like how the eye works, is happening that's very anti-Trump.
Mm-hmm. And it's almost like Twitter has censored like 50 of Trump's tweets and not a single one of Joe Biden ever.
Yeah.
It's bullshit.
When it comes to this fact-checking shit, it's just all bullshit.
We were talking to Danny, great point. And if you look at the stock for Twitter, it was dying. And Donald Trump, 4 years ago, brought it back.
It's true.
From the dead, dude. He brought Twitter back.
I've been reading a lot, and I've been relating this to other points I've made in podcasts about J.P. Morgan right now. That's the book I'm reading. And it talks about how even at the dawn of the 20th century, 1900, at that point, bankers already dwarfed presidents as far as power. Mm-hmm. William McKinley was J.P. Morgan's little bitch. J.P. Morgan and Teddy Roosevelt had to spar a lot because Teddy Roosevelt, basically, before he did anything of consequence, had to check in with J.P., the biggest banker in America. Bankers exert influence over presidents by bribing them and paying them for fucking their campaigns that the president can't finance on their own. Right. And by doing that, the president owes them a bunch of favors. You can't do that to Trump because he's a multi-billionaire. Mm-hmm. So just on that level, that if it was going on in 1900, it's going on 20-fold now. The money men behind the scenes can't bribe Trump. Mm-hmm. So they're fucking pissed. And so they're paying NBC and Coca-Cola and Twitter and Facebook to get this guy out of fucking office.
100%.
And if that's what I think's going on, and if they have that sort of power, it's nothing for them to slip into a polling place outside of Detroit, Michigan, and put up some butcher paper in the window and douse some fucking voting boxes in gasoline and kill all the Trump votes. I completely believe it.
Absolutely. And I feel like cheating in politics has probably been a thing that's been going on forever, right?
Specifically, like Philadelphia and Detroit, where they're having a lot of these legal battles, they're notorious for having election fraud issues in these areas.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's crazy that we ever trusted presidential elections. There are so many people involved.
So many people.
Every single person, this election in particular, felt very strongly one way or the other.
Mm-hmm. And did you see the news today? Of course, when Biden gets elected or they think he's going to win, they released the news that there's a vaccine that was 95% effective.
I saw that.
Yeah, they waited until after the election so Trump didn't take credit for it.
The stock market blew the fuck up today.
I know.
Did you see that shit?
And you and I have been making some coin in that.
That's right, baby.
Nice.
Absolutely, I saw that, Leo. Yeah. It's too convenient, right?
Way too convenient.
You know who said this, and it really stuck with me. When I hung out with R.A.L. Pink, who was in the Beatles video, Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, Danny Mullen's Wretched YouTube Club, R.A.L. Pink and I went out to dinner before that video to feel each other out, to make sure we were artistically compatible. And on top of him spending a lot of time watching Donald Trump highlights, he's obsessed with Donald Trump. He was just watching owned highlights and these really 2080 highlights of liberals crying and with music added. He told me that he feels like right now with the coronavirus, with BLM, like the liberals were pissed and bitter that their side was losing. And it was if a kid was losing a board game. And instead of being a sportsman and going out with dignity, the child had grabbed the board and capsized it and knocked all the pieces to the floor. And that's what the liberals were doing with fucking coronavirus and BLM. And it's true. And then now that Trump has, it seems, no longer he's going to be the president. Right. And now the vaccine's coming out. Now racial unity and everything's all good.
Fucking school shooting's going to come back, dude, for sure. You like school
shooting? I was into that one, yeah.
You're into that one. You fucking assholes. But yeah, man, it's going to be interesting to see what happens in the next month or two. Well, we'll know by when. January, for sure, Trump has to concede by what date, Austin?
January something.
Mm-hmm. So I guess we'll see. We shall see. I think the Danny Mullen channel, what do you think? With a liberal president or a conservative president, where do you think we dominate more?
That's a good question. It seems like our kind of humor gets a lot less negativity and a lot less censorship in a Democratic presidential era.
Yes.
And I'm basing that on the fact that I went to UCLA, a very liberal college, when Obama was in office and nobody talked about politics. Mm-mm. I remember once I made a joke about Mexicans sweeping up our vomit and our broken glass after parties to a girl who was a Democratic socialist. And she said, "Hey, that's offensive." And that's the only backlash I got for doing anything despicable at UCLA. Wow. Which nowadays I'd walk out of my house being white and somebody would throw an egg at me.
Yeah, I feel if you went to UCLA now and you were the Danny Mullen that you are, you would have wrote some tweet or whatever. Like, you would have been canceled. Like, they would have tried to cancel you. You wouldn't have been canceled. I think you're uncancelable. But they would have tried to. They might have, like, hit up your work and shit, like, your old job, and been like, "This guy wrote this," and stuff like that. Yeah.
I think it's all going to get worse, honestly. You would think that it would get better, but I think it's going to get worse under Biden. I mean,
why?
Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez tweeted, "We need to start making an archived list of everyone who supported Trump so that in the future they can't pretend they didn't support Trump and that they won't get hired for jobs and shit."
She said that?
Yeah. Jesus. People are like, "We need to come together for unity and purge the earth from the Trumpian scum." I'm like, that's not coming together by just shunning everyone you don't like and saying that we need to put them on lists.
We'll see, man. The thing is, we're going to forge on forward no matter what happens.
Yeah.
So it's irrelevant to me because I think our sense of humor is going to be the same.
Right.
Yeah, I think it's less about the president we have and more about how contentious everything is. And I think the more infighting we have in America, the better it is for us.
I kind of agree. I think when Trump is in office and everybody hates Trump and all of his supporters, that mobilizes fans to us.
Yeah.
Because they see us as one of them. And it's this very tribal mentality. Mm-hmm. Whereas if it goes back to just kind of, oh, you like this Republican? Oh, that's cool. I'm a Democrat. Then maybe we'll be less visible and there'll be less word of mouth going on. But there's nothing we can do about it. Whatever. We'll just keep making content.